everyone, this is Jivita's World, and we are soon to take a trip to Mount Kailash. Mount Kailash is going to be the bomb of a trip, and I invite everyone to come with me. I'm definitely going. I went to Everest a couple of years ago, and I've been to the Annapurna Sanctuary, so I'm pretty much of a seasoned mountain climber, but you don't have to be a mountain climber to go to Kailash. Kailash is an easy trip, basically, because all of your needs will be taken care of. What I will do a little bit today is talk to you about what do you need to take to Kailash, and a little bit about what is this trip all about. Mount Kailash is 22,000 feet above sea level, but of course when we get to the base it's only 15,000 feet. And as we talked earlier, it's very important that you prepare yourself as you rise in elevation. Shizandra is the herb of choice. It's an adaptogenic tonic and it will help your body become strong and capable of oxygenating the bloodstream. Because as we're going to the higher altitudes, it's very important that our body is strong and that our blood is carrying enough oxygen. So Shizandra is definitely the Himalayan herb that you need to take. You can get it in any pharmacy and it's available for all. Hiking boots are an absolute necessity, and the more expensive boots are the best. So taking hiking boots that you can buy at your local outdoor shop, getting the right fit, getting the person to help you fit you with the right fitting is going to be very, very important as you're hiking, because you're going to be using your feet every day on this trip. So it's very important that they be comfortable. Lightweight socks, both cotton and wool socks, because it may get very hot during the day but very cool at night. So thin cotton socks and thin wool socks. Another very important thing is sunglasses. You've got to be sure that you have expensive sunglasses. Don't buy the cheap version like these are. These were 90 rupees in Bidadi. So you want to get some sunglasses that have UV protection, and get a pair of very nice sunglasses. You can get them anywhere, a pair of $20, $30 sunglasses, but that will give protection for your eyes. Once again, bring clothing that can be layered, so that you might have a top made out of cotton and then have a layer of warm sweater, thin sweater, that will go over the top or underneath. It gets very hot during the day, but very cold at night. So you have to be prepared with layers. Having a jacket that will fit easily in your backpack, and having a backpack that fits well on your body, are another two items that's absolutely important for this trip. Having a backpack that puts the weight on your hips with a strap that you can carry the weight on your hips is very important. Not one that just hangs off of your shoulders, because there's no support for that type of backpack, and that can cause a lot of back problems if you use that type of backpack. So having a pair of sunglasses, sunscreen, shoes, and socks. These are items that are absolute necessities for our trip to Kailash. And I'm looking forward to everyone coming to this trip. It's going to be a blast. Cosmologists and those who are interested in the origin of the universe claim that Mount Kailash is actually the Axis Mundi. And the Axis Mundi means the center and birthplace of the Earth, of the entire world. It's the abode of Chakrasamvara. Chakrasamvara is the Buddhist god of birth, maintenance, and destruction, and he's the grantor of enlightenment. Going to Kailash will be an amazing journey over the landscape of Tibet. The hillsides are covered with beautiful verdant greenery, flowers like lavender, and beautiful skies, the landscape of the sky and the mountains coming together. Beautiful colors of clouds and sky, and almost like a moonscape at times. We'll be taking a Land Rover or four-wheel drive vehicles. We'll be flying into Kathmandu. Kathmandu is another amazing place in Nepal, and we'll be moving across the terrain on from Kathmandu up to the base of Kailash. Once again, we want to make sure that we carry some warm clothes. Actually, during the day it can get quite warm, so wearing something like this that's sleeveless and having some clothing that we can use for layers is the most appropriate type of clothing to take for this trip. The amazing part of this trip is that we're going with enlightened Master Paramahamsa Nityananda, who is the embodiment of Shiva himself. And as you know, Kailash is the abode of Shiva and Parvati. It is the place at the very summit where those energies come together that have the most powerful effect on the mind and the body and the soul. And the transcendent nature of being at this height of awareness, both with the enlightened master and being at the most revered and most religious place in the center of the universe, is going to be quite an event. So everyone needs to come to this Kailash adventure. I guarantee you that I can prepare you and give you the knowledge and the ideas and the clothing and the good things that you'll need to bring along with you so that you can have a great trip. We're going to have the Sangha, everyone together, eating together, telling stories with a campfire at night with the enlightened master, having fun along the way, joking, laughing our way to enlightenment. Another great aspect about Kailash is that the lake Manasarova is just around the corner. It's about 13 miles from the base of the mountain, and Manasarova is a beautiful lake, very clean, very pristine, healing waters. Manas means mind. Sarova is body of water. So it's the body of water that creates purity of mind and enlightenment. So we have many opportunities to get together and experience the Sangha, to become one with the mountain, to become one with Shiva, and to experience enlightenment with our master Paramahamsa Nityananda. So come one, come all, join us on this wonderful and once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to go to the one mountain, the Meru of the universe. Nityanandam. Nityanandaya namaha. Om Hrim. Nityanandaya namaha. Nityanandaya namaha.